Good morning, it's Loren Lockman from the Tanglewood Wellness Center in Costa Rica. I'm here this morning with my dear friend Ziv, who is leaving us today after 6 weeks with us. It's going to feel a little different around here without you, as it does when everybody leaves. Each person leaves their mark and their energy. So perhaps you can share a little bit about your experience here. First of all, maybe you can let everybody know who you are, where you're from, and why you decided to come fast to Tanglewood.
Okay. My name is Loren. I recently turned 30. I'm Israeli who lives in Finland. And
that's an anomaly, I'm sure. Can't be too many of those.
Yeah. And well, the main reason I chose to come to Tanglewood to fast was because in the last 3 years I've been suffering from a hiatal hernia, and that have led to many other problems. And
sure.
That just disabled me over these 3 years from doing many, many things.
Well, let's for just a moment, I mean, for those who don't know, a hiatal hernia is where the stomach actually pushes through the hiatus, the ring that separates the stomach from the esophagus. And people usually wind up with belching, acid reflux. What other symptoms were you experiencing?
Well, my digestion was also very, very bad. I was going to the bathroom just once a day.
Wow.
And even though I ate large quantities of fruits, yeah, and vegetables,
yeah,
mostly raw diet,
yeah,
yet still had a lot of
right.
issues and, with digestion.
And you've been living now on a fruit-based raw diet for how long?
Well,
mostly raw.
In about 3 years.
About actually. 3 years. Eating, about the same time.
Yeah, eating raw during the day and was still eating one cooked meal in the evening.
Okay. Yeah. All right. And over that 3 years, did you see any improvement in your condition?
Not at all. Sadly, no. I was, it actually became worse, and I was had to go and have to take anti-acids.
Yeah.
Because the acid reflux was so bad, it actually caused me ulcers.
Okay, yeah, so, you know, it's just interesting to note because there are so many people out there who will say silly things like a raw food diet will heal your body, when I think you and I are both really clear, the body heals itself.
Exactly.
You know, in the absence of the garbage many people are eating, their body can heal itself with certain conditions. But because it's never the diet, it's always the body may not heal with any diet. In some situations, that was certainly your situation.
Mm-hmm.
So you came to Tanglewood from Finland, a long journey, and you fasted for 30 days and spent 12 days refeeding. And maybe you can tell a bit about your experience. How was the fast itself for you?
Well, the experience overall it was amazing, because I went from coming here with a severe hiatal hernia and all the symptoms that comes with it, end up having almost no symptoms at all, feeling like the hernia is now completely going away,
right,
leaving the body. So
okay.
I'm just like overwhelmed by the power of the body to heal itself.
It's incredible, isn't it?
If you give it the right condition.
That's right. And you know, it's important. I'm so glad you said that, because it's critically important to understand. I mean, you know, people think, it's, you know, Loren's full of crap. He talks like fasting is magic. No, fasting is not magic. It simply allows us to get out of the body's way, so the body can heal itself. And we've seen, you know, what medicine would say is miraculous, because medicine says there is no cure. I mean, the only thing that I can offer you is surgery, which is, do you know what the percentage of success is with that?
I think that the thing is with the surgery is that even for the people that it succeed, it still may come back during their lifetime at some
right.
point.
Right.
So there is no really 70, 80%.
Okay, so in other words, 70 or 80% experience immediate relief because they no longer have the problem. But, you know, just keep in mind, as I've been saying now for 20+ years in the last 3 or 4 years on YouTube, surgery and drugs and supplements and smoothies and green foods, these things are not dealing with the underlying cause of the problem. Right? I mean, if you do surgery to get the stomach back where it belongs, the question is, why did that happen in the first place? And if you haven't done anything about the underlying conditions, of course it'll come back. Why wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Right? So, all right. So, overall, amazing experience for you in terms of healing. How about, I mean, you spent 6 weeks at a place, you know, with almost nothing to do except look for problems. You know, how is your overall experience with the center?
Okay, so the center is a beautiful place. It really, it's located in just a magnificent area. And it's very allowing to just relax and be yourself and connect with the nature, because you hear the sounds of the birds and the monkeys, and you breathe clean air, and just it's just the perfect place to do a fast. You're away from your family, your friends, your partner in life. You're completely able to concentrate on yourself and your process.
Right.
And it's very important because many things may come up mentally during the fast.
Emotionally.
Yeah. And if you're doing it at home, or if you're not in a good environment to do it, you may not be able to deal with all these things in the best way possible.
Well, in fact, we've seen that, haven't we? I mean, we had a young man here who worked very, very hard to get here and wanted to be here for 6 or 8 weeks and was only able to arrange to come for 4, and then bailed after about a week. Because, you know, for whatever reasons he might say, I mean, I think we can agree, wasn't really dealing with the emotional piece. I mean, I've always stressed that, and it's challenging. It's probably the hardest thing for most people. I mean, you had some pretty rough physical experiences too, didn't you?
I did, but in the mental part of it, I chose to just give in to the process, not fight it, but just accept whatever feeling comes up and rise from within me.
Perfect.
And deal with it. And, you know, once I did that work, everything shifted for the better. Like, I started experiencing an uplifting mood, and I felt so mentally stable. Like, I released so much mental baggage that I was carrying for no reason, because it didn't serve me whatsoever.
Well, we carry it because we're trained, that's what we do. Right? It's just how we've been acculturated, and it never even occurs to us to question it so much of the time. I mean, I would say question everything, right? don't take anything at face value just because it's been that way that it should be that way. All right. Well, is there anything else you'd like to share with people about your experience? Or?
Well, it's just it's amazing when you get here, and you also people may not know it, but we get to learn from you each day about natural hygiene, about healthy living.
Yeah,
that you cover so many different issues and topics, and just that is priceless.
Well, thank you. I'm glad. You know, I'm sure I consistently fail to do this as well as I'd like to, but the goal is to send you guys out of here knowing everything you need to know, so that you can continue to consistently create the same amazing level of health that you're experiencing now. Because it's entirely possible that we never get sick, that we always feel amazing, have tons of energy, body works perfectly well. But unfortunately, a lot of people don't know how to do that, don't know what to do. So that's the objective there. But thanks for those kind words. Anything else at all you want to share?
Well, I would really like to suggest people who come to fast to really be present in the process and put all their old beliefs and prejudiced opinions about diet, nutrition, healthy living, just about any belief, and just put
all
it aside,
it.
You know?
Yeah.
And being in what you taught us as a beginner's mind, in an open mind, and just try to listen as much and learn as much as possible and rest as much as possible.
Yeah.
And allow yourself to heal, because this is an amazing opportunity and just one of the best thing I ever did for myself in my life.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Definitely.
That's wonderful. Well, listen, it's truly been a pleasure having you here with us, Siv. I look forward to seeing you again. I know we're going to see each other eventually.
Sure.
And I'm looking forward to that. And thanks so much for sharing.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.